welcome back to my channel. Today I have done the natural, easy version of the domed eyeshadow look that I did for my last video, which was more glamorous and maybe more of an evening slash event look. So this one is the natural, very quick, very easy version of that. So like I said in my last video, if you have hooded eyes, a lot of the videos that I do are actually catered towards hooded eyes because having them myself, I know that they are awkward to apply makeup on. So this is another technique that I have found that really complements hooded eyes and brings out their beauty. Of course you can wear this if you don't have hooded eyes as well, but if you do have hooded eyes, this is a foolproof option for you. To make this video a little bit shorter, I've already got my foundation on, my contouring, my eyebrows, and my lips actually already done. For my foundation, I used the Maybelline Air Mousse. I don't know, it'll be linked in the description box down below and the color and everything. I set that in place with my Australis Fresh and Flawless powder, again linked in the description box. On my cheeks I have this illuminator here. This is the Mary Luminizer from the Balm. For my contour I used the Bahama Mama contour powder from the Balm, and on my lips I have, what do I have? I can't remember. I'll have that linked in the description box for you. And I think that was it. Okay, so the first color I'm going to be taking is this one here. It looks kind of like a poo brown color on camera, but in real life, it's kind of like a green toned bronze, if that makes any sense. It's nice and matte, so it is perfect for hooded eyes if you have hooded eyes. I'm using a big fluffy blending brush and I'm going to sweep it all through my crease to start off with. Remember, we're working in a dome shape here, so don't bring it past the inner corner of your eye, so like don't bring it into here for example, and try not to bring it anywhere past the outer corner of your eye either. So you just want to work from here to here and bring it up in a dome shape like that. If you feel like you would have more control using your finger, by all means use your finger. Sometimes I do, just to make sure that you get it in the right shape and also to make sure that you can get the color as close to the lash line as possible. And then I'm going to use my brush to blend it out. With this dome effect, it's all about the blending and the building up. So what I do, I like to apply one layer, blend it out, apply a second layer, blend it out until you get the desired depth of color that you want. I'm putting my second layer on now. And blend. What you need to do now is look at yourself front on in your mirror. If your eyeshadow is hidden underneath your hood, that just shows you that you need to bring the eyeshadow up further. So keep bringing it up little bit by little bit until your hood is covered with the eyeshadow, and then blend it out from there. And that'll tell you how high you actually need to bring up your eyeshadow as well. Now I'm going to even my other eye up because this one is very naked right now. Alright, now I'm taking a small flat eyeshadow brush, and this is the Sigma E32, and I'm just going to take that exact same colour and I'm going to blend it out underneath my lower lash line. Keep it as close to your lower lash line as possible, and then what I'm going to do is kind of join it up with this part here. So you want a slight winged, kind of blown out effect with your eyeshadow, but nothing too much. Now I'm taking this flat little chunky eyeshadow brush here and this colour, which you can't see on my camera whatsoever. It's like a very, very pale yellow highlight shade and it's called Spellbinding. Yes, Spellbinding. I'm going to apply that to the inner corners of the eyes and also underneath the arch of the brow bone. Now I'm going to take a little bit more of that same colour on my finger, choose a clean finger, and I'm going to plonk that right on the middle of the mobile lid there. So don't put it up on the hood of the eye, keep it right on the mobile lid. It doesn't matter if it's visible or not. And just pat that into place. Like that, and that'll just give your eyes a subtle little pop. Now I'm going to smudge a little bit of black eyeliner through the roots of my top lash line. So I'm not really going to put it on the waterline as such. What I do is I close my eyes, and if I can feel that this eyeliner is running through the roots of my top lashes, that's good, that's what you want. So it kind of just makes them look a little bit more bulky, a little bit more thick, and it kind of frames the eyes a little bit more, but it's not going to end up transferring onto the lower lash line. This is the Chanel Waterproof Eyeliner, Dealer U, something like that. like that. So you can see it doesn't make too much of a difference, but it does make a slight difference. That is the eye with the liner, that's the eye with no liner yet. Now I'm going to apply mascara to my top and bottom. Wait, no I'm not. Hold that thought. I'm going to apply an eye brightener. This is the Sigma Unclouded Inner Rim Brightener. Inner Rim Brightener, that's what I meant, not eye brightener. This is a white eyeliner, but it's got a slight shimmer to it as well. I'm just going to be applying that to the inner rim of the lower lash line. I'm going to apply mascara to my top and bottom lashes. I'm using the Chanel La Volume mascara in black. You could go and apply some false eyelashes now if you want to, but I've kind of created this look to be more of a natural, everyday, you know, workable look, so I'm not going to bother with any false lashes at all. I think mascara does the job just fine for this kind of thing, but the option's there if you want it. And that is the finished look. So as you can see, that was so quick, so easy. We literally used two eyeshadow colors, which for me is a rarity. So I hope you enjoy that look. If you've got any questions, as always, just leave them in the comments down below for me so I can get back to you. Please follow me on Twitter and Instagram. My Twitter is Steffi Lang MUA and my Instagram is Stephanie Lang Makeup. That'll be in the description box down below in case you do want to come and say hi on there. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. There should be a little button in one of these corners to make it nice and easy for you. Every single thing that I've used, every product that I've mentioned will be linked in the description box as well to make life easier for you guys. I love you guys so much. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!